93 WIBC, it's Terry Stacey. If you're a part of a family with more than three kids, we're told that the firstborn is the egocentric, the third is and always will be the baby. And if you are the one born in the middle, it's said that you're the one that is the most independent, and that's because you are the one that is neglected. That's what we're told. Joining us once again to talk about the Super Bowl is the big crybaby himself, middle child advocate blogger Bruce Hopman, the International Middle Child Union boss and the Middle Child Party founder, and he's very busy. So we're glad to have some time with him this morning. Hello, Bruce. How are you?
Good morning. I wish I could say that was the first time somebody called me a crybaby, but unfortunately it's not. I guess I'll just live with that title along with the other ones.
Bruce joined us around Christmas time. He did a wonderful rendition of "Twas the Night Before Christmas," as seen through the eyes of a middle child. It was
not a dry eye in the house.
It was very sad.
It was an emotional time.
We had a lot of people calling and wanting a copy. This is Super Bowl 48, and Bruce, this has caught your attention, has it not?
It has. And actually, I'm glad you just cleared that up for me, because I was trying to figure out. I can't count that high in Roman. Yeah. I didn't know what that XLV111 was, 48. So
yeah.
I'm glad we got that.
Just a bit of trivia. They didn't start using the Roman numerals until the fourth Super Bowl, just for trivia, just in case you need to know it, middle child. Something interesting. Yeah, write that down. The Super Bowl has caught your attention. Why?
Well, you know, here's our charge at the International Middle Child Union. My goal is to keep the middle child in the spotlight for as much of the year as possible. You know, August 12th is Middle Child's Day, and we do a big thing, and we try to get our all attention then. But one day is clearly not enough if you're a middle child. You need that attention year-round.
Sure.
So I, throughout the year, try to cover events, stage our own events, to draw attention to the middle child.
Mm-hmm.
So
mm-hmm.
The Super Bowl, I mean, what bigger stage can you get than the Super Bowl?
The Super Bowl, but how does this relate to middle children? I don't understand.
Well, here you go. I mean, you call it the Super Bowl. I call it the Middle Child Syndrome Bowl. In this year's Super Bowl, you have a matchup, a marquee matchup of middle child quarterbacks. Now, you are all in Indianapolis well aware of Peyton Manning. Maybe all those other things he did for the city and the team.
Yeah.
Overshadowed the fact that he is a middle child.
I didn't even think about it. He is a middle child. Cooper. Cooper is the oldest.
Exactly. And Eli. Peyton, one of the greatest quarterbacks to ever play the game, middle child.
He's not really advocating that. He's not really, you know, and he'd be a great spokesperson for you.
Of course. But he's not on Twitter. I try to reach out to all these middle children, but they don't return my calls, Terry. Geez, I could barely get you to return my calls. How am I going to get Peyton Manning to return my call? On the other side, on the Seahawks, you've got Russell Wilson, a middle child. Now, we could focus on them for a minute. I mean, obviously, big differences between the two. Manning is 37 years old. Wilson is 25 years old. That's the biggest, the largest age gap between two starting Super Bowl quarterbacks ever, almost 13 years.
I didn't know.
And, you know, Manning has set every record in the book. You know, he's in his 13th Pro Bowl,
sure,
more than any other quarterback. You know, he's an icon. Russell Wilson, this is only his second year, but they're both middle children. And by the way, among all the other awards that Peyton Manning has won, he's also, as I'm sure you're also not aware, he's a winner of the prestigious Smack Dab Middle Child Sportsman of the Year Award.
I didn't know that. This is award season.
At the Smack Dab blog, he has been named, I believe, multiple times the Middle Child Sportsman of the Year. So there you got that's one huge marquee matchup right there. You got the two starting quarterbacks.
Yeah.
Now, take it down a level on defense. On the Broncos side, you've got Champ Bailey. Now, Champ Bailey is a cornerback for the Broncos. He's been to the Pro Bowl 12 times. Do people know that he's a middle child?
No.
Of course not. But he is a middle child. And, you know, he's been playing the game a long time. They say he's one of those players who's the best of, you know, at his position to never play in a Super Bowl. And on the other side of the ball, you've got that other cornerback.
Who is it?
Richard Sherman. I like to say, what can I say about Richard Sherman that Richard Sherman hasn't already said about Richard Sherman? This guy, I mean, Champ Bailey plays the game, doesn't really talk a lot. The complete opposite of Richard Sherman. Richard Sherman, brash talking, trash talking, but really good. So you got that matchup also. So there's a lot of middle children playing each other. Now, naturally, I took it a step further. I went and looked at the rosters of both teams because I'm making my Super Bowl pick.
Sure.
I've got to base it on something middle child oriented. I looked at the starting rosters of both the Broncos and the Seahawks to analyze, to confirm, to see how many middle children are each starting roster.
Ooh, did you get some good accurate numbers?
Now this is also shocking. You're not going to believe this.
Okay.
The NFL compiles statistics on everything, sacks and passes defended and blocks and everything. Do you believe that they don't, an NFL stat isn't what is your birth order? I mean, shocking to me. Shocking to me. So I've been up late. I've been studying a lot of film. I've been digging through. I can't confirm. I cannot find out the birth, you know, order status of every player. Unbelievable. Shocking to me. All part of the vast middle child conspiracy. But, you know, one thing at a time. I was able to confirm from my research that the Denver Broncos have more middle children starting than the Seattle Seahawks.
So really,
so of the ones I've been able to confirm, they are, and you know what? What does it matter anyway? This is my pick, and it means nothing. So, but that's why I'm basing my pick. I'm going to go with the Broncos because they have more middle children. And here's one of the reasons I'm going to do that. Middle children are not really known for being the best sports. I mean, we are sore sports. We do not like to lose.
Yeah, but are you athletic? I mean, how are you in the world of sports? Are you pretty athletic people, that middle child?
I was an okay athlete, but I know I was not a good sport. I will say this. I remember playing basketball once with my brother on the driveway, and he did something to humiliate me in front of my friends. And I'm ashamed to admit this. I kicked my brother so hard in a part that you're not supposed to kick your brother that even now when I kind of approach him to just talk to him, he kind of flinches away because he's still, you know, afraid something's going to happen. So I athletic ability, I don't know, maybe not. Even though these guys are great athletes, so I don't think that's the case. But I know we don't like to lose.
Yeah.
So I want to make sure that there are more happy players, happy middle children at the end of the game.
You know,
so that's why I'm going for the Broncos.
You know, with us this morning, by the way, Bruce Hopman, the International Middle Child Union boss and Middle Child Party founder. You can certainly read his SmackDab blog, smackdabblog.com, where he talks about all things middle child. What do we take away from this middle child syndrome bowl, as you call it?
Well, I think my pick is the Broncos. I think they're gonna win the game based on my middle child analysis.
Uh-huh.
As far as fans go, you know, if you're a middle child, if your team doesn't win, whatever happens here, there's going to be a lot of unhappy middle children, and I can't do anything about that. So I'm just trying to maximize the, you know, that's why I'm going. Let's go with Denver because then maybe there are more players that'll be happy about it. The other aspect about the middle childness of this Super Bowl, besides all the players that are in there and these marquee matchups, you look at where Super Bowls are played in the past.
Uh-huh.
They're usually in really nice, warm weather locations, right? It's California, San Diego, mm-hmm. Florida, right?
Right.
When they're not in warm weather locations, when they're in Indianapolis, they're in a dome. When they're in Detroit, they're in a dome.
Right.
Where is this Super Bowl? Is being played in a swamp in New Jersey in February. I mean, if this is not the middle child of all Super Bowls ever, I don't know what is. I mean, I am from New Jersey originally.
I was going to say,
So I can say this. It's not really the most scenic location. You got oil refineries nearby. I mean, I'm kind of, you know, I'm laughing when I'm seeing all these reporters who are like, live from Jersey City, we're going to go to Secaucus now. These are not like, you know, dream locations. You know, you don't dream of playing football your whole life so you could play a championship game in Jersey. Just not the way it goes. So this is definitely the middle child syndrome.
Now, Bruce, before we let you go, and you're going to come back and see us next week, and we're going to talk about the Olympics, because I know you have a whole big take on the Olympics as well, and middle children involved in the Olympics. You know, it might overwhelm us, but I'd love to have you back.
Looking at everything through the distorted lens of a middle child, yes, even the sports world.
Yeah.
Yes,
we're going to talk about the Olympics. But now, what will you be eating as a middle child? Do you all have things that you all kind of do you like salty things? Do you like it's a big eating day as well.
What a silly question. We are middle children, Terry, so we will be eating leftovers. I mean, come on. I mean, whatever. Here's what we'll be eating. Whatever my brothers and sisters' favorite snack foods are, that's what we will be eating. I mean,
Oh, it's so sad.
Easy answers.
Well, I didn't know. I had no idea. Bruce Hopman. And again, if you would like to find out more about all things middle child, visit smackdabblog.com. You also find him on Facebook or follow Bruce on Twitter at MidKidMusings.
Hey, look, and I'm a middle child. I say go Broncos. But you know what? If the Broncos lose, I say go Seahawks, because there's middle children on both teams and we hate to lose. So I'll flip my pick in a second.
Bruce, see you next week.
All right. Thanks a lot, Terry.
Bruce Hopman, ladies and gentlemen. I find him very, very entertaining. We'll have him back next week. All right. Coming up, we've got today's top stories. That's next on 93 WIBC and WIBC.com. WIBC.com.